Hi, Steve at DrumDial. Next in our series of advanced drum tuning topics, I'll explain the finer points of banjo head tuning. When first seating the banjo head, use the two-key seating method from our first video. Use the 12 o'clock, 6 o'clock, 9 o'clock, 3 o'clock tuning pattern. Then 10 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 8 o'clock, 2 o'clock, and so on. The goal here is to be sure to seat the head as evenly as possible. Now, when top tuning, stay to the inside edge of the pot or tone ring. Remember, for top tuning, you won't be able to get as close to the strings. And if tuning from the underside of the banjo head, stay close to the inside edge and get as close to the rods as you can. Make sure your banjo hooks sit flat against the hoop and don't twist. If too much tension is applied unevenly, the top of the hook will bend. So tune in small increments as we work our tension higher on the drum dial. Now watch the dial as I tighten the nut to give you an idea of how much to tighten each section of the drum head. Again, tighten in small increments. Now watch closely as the dial moves as I tighten this nut. So just remember to tune a little at a time in a circular pattern, one lug after the next, but only after seating the head. Watch the needle move as I tighten this nut. Don't tighten too much. This lug is good. I'll bring this next lug up to 79. Good. Again, small increments, circular pattern, one lug after the next. And ultimately, we'll be tuning this head to 89. It really doesn't matter which side of the head you tune from, so long as the bridge and strings are not holding the weight of the banjo. It's the same reading. So tune from whichever side is easier. Keep in mind that when tuning a drum head, the head must be mechanically in tune with itself. Otherwise, it'll come out of tune faster than it took to tune it. If the drum is mechanically in tune, you'll have a greater sustain and a drum head that won't detune on its own. DrumDial is very accurate and keeps your banjo head balanced and in tune. Tap tuning can be deceiving. Not if you're using a drum dial. Why can't frequency meters be used to tune a banjo head? Too many tuning harmonics. Like an adjustable head, movable bridge, the resonator, and the string tension all make harmonic tuning of the head very difficult for any frequency meter. A guitar has a fixed bridge and soundboard. The tone is the same and is not meant to be changed. But on the other hand, we have a completely different story, the banjo. The beauty of this instrument is in its movable bridge. Even a compensated bridge is meant to be moved. We also have a fully adjustable soundboard. The banjo soundboard is its drum head, and these tuning hooks make that possible. Now, never use a frequency meter for head tuning. Harmonic tuning with a frequency meter is almost impossible. I'll show you exactly how the resonator affects the sound of the banjo by comparing the resonator and banjo head spacing with this drum. Now, the resonator reflects the sound just like this drum does. Without a back surface for the sound to reflect, this drum has a higher pitch and little sustain or resonance. When I set the drum down, the sound reflects and resonates loudly with a much lower pitch. The center of the head always has a lower pitch than the edge. No matter how hard I tap, I can't get the center G string to ring without the resonator in place. This is because there is no sound reflection to vibrate the head. Plus, the head is at a much higher resonant frequency than any of the strings. The edge of the resonator opening around the banjo pot and its size determine the sound. The sound reflects, forces, and scoops the air, making the sound bounce and vibrate against the bridge. With the resonator, our high-pitched head becomes lower. The sound and air move around and out the sides of the pot and also moves and vibrates the head and bridge. The sound wave moves up. The sound bounces up, and the G string rings. The peaks on the screen in the background are all of the frequencies that are being made as I tap the head. This side shows the lower frequencies, and those on the right side are the higher frequencies. When I dampen the strings, these frequencies are primarily the drum head. The others are the dampened strings and overtones that the banjo is making as I tap it. I'll analyze the data and add filters to measure the correct head frequencies next. The head's a G sharp with the resonator in place. Drum frequency tuners can't read above 400 Hz and cause false lug pitch matching. Their built-in filters only take an average of the loudest frequency. This next drum was tuned with only a frequency meter to 277 Hz, a C sharp. The lug pitches don't match. Those are false readings. The drum is not in tune with itself. Listen to the really poor harmonics here. Now let's double check with the drum dial. 85, that's good. 83, wow, that's our warbling problem. Very poor harmonics. 84, again, very frustrating. Drum frequency tuners are often inaccurate and give most users a drum that is poorly tuned. Heads tuned with a drum dial are louder and have a much longer sustain. Because drum dial is so accurate, the drums stay in tune for a very long time. 83 should have started with a drum dial. Your drum head is automatically frequency tuned with a drum dial because it allows you to balance and mechanically tune the head at the same time. For example, when you balance a car tire, the RPM meter is similar to the frequency meter. It'll tell you how fast the tire rotates, but can never tell you if it's out of balance or wobbles or not. Frequency meters alone often leave the drum out of tune with very poor harmonics.